One more time, I am repeating all the points from this chapter for the easy study of this chapter. So here we are discussing the chapter reproduction in organism. Okay, so reproduction means it's a biological process. The new organisms are arise from the parent body. The parent body, a new organism is arising in case of the asexual reproduction. They are just as the clones. Clones means they are just the copies of the parental organism. All organism not having the equal lifespan. So the period between the birth and the natural death of an organism is known as lifespan. Lifespan is varies from minutes to 100 years. Okay, in case of banyan tree and peepal plant, the peepal tree, it will lead to 1000. Okay, sequoia plant, redwood tree. So it in sequoia plant, 4000 to 3000 years they can live. But in case of bacteria, they live only for a minutes. Okay, so there are organism with extremely short lifespan and extensively long lifespan. Okay, there is no correlation between the lifespan and the body size. Comparing the size of the crow and the parrot, we can see that parrot having 140 years lifespan and the crow having 15 years of lifespan. Okay, and also another evidence is mango tree and the peepal tree. Okay. So the death of every individual is inevitable except in case of single cell organism. Hence the bacteria are said to be immortal. Okay, in each minute or in each time, in seconds, the new organisms are forming by the protoplasmic components. Okay, so that is known as successive generation. But in case of other organism, higher organism, it is not possible. So each organism having their own lifespan. Okay, so try to study the organism's lifespan in our NCERT textbook. Okay, so different organism having different lifespan. For example, crow having 15 years, eagle 90 years, and parrot 140 years. Butterfly and that type of insects like they having some butterfly having 1 to 2 weeks. Fruit fly they having 15 to 30 days. House fly 15 to 30 days. Then the man having 80 to 100, and we know that some deviations be like this. Then rat having 2 to 4 years. Then the reproduction is said, it is a biological process in which the new organisms are arise from the parent. Okay, so they having the some characteristics of the parent. In case of asexual reproduction, they are just clone, and then case of sexual reproduction, they are varying from their parent. Okay, so the mode of reproductions are classified into two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In case of asexual reproduction, only one individual participant is needed. So there is no formation of the gametes or the fusion of the gametes. The type of reproduction is known as asexual reproduction. But in the case of sexual reproduction, two partners are required. Two partners means male partner and female partners are required. Okay, and there occur the fusion of the gametes are also be occurred. And these asexual reproductions are common in very single organism or single organism. The common type of asexual reproductions are fission and cyst. And cyst means spore formation, budding, fragmentation, zoospores, conidia, gametes, vegetative reproduction. All these are the examples of asexual reproduction. The first one that we discussed, that is fission. In case of fission, the parental body divides into two. If the parental body divides into two, that is known as binary fission. If the parental body divides into multiple pieces, that is known as multiple fission. So amoeba is an example for the binary fission, and the plasmodium is an example for the multiple fission. The next is sporulation. Sporulation means encystation. Okay, in case of amoeba also, the spores are forming during the favorable condition. The encysted amoeba means the process by encystation, they are withdrawing their pseudopodia. And make a thick covering of cyst. Okay, and make a thick covering of cyst, that form that particular stage is known as encystation. During favorable condition, the encysted amoeba divides by multiple fission and produce produce many minute amoeba. Okay, so otherwise it is known as pseudopodia spores. Pseudopodia spores. The cyst wall burst out and the spores are liberated and each spore become new amoeba. The old events are known as sporulation. So in case of amoeba, not only fusion, sometimes the sporulation also takes place. So what is sporulation? The production of spores are known as sporulation. During favorable conditions, the encysted amoeba, encysted means withdrawing of the pseudopodia and enveloped by a cyst. Okay, the cyst is thick layer. Encysted amoeba divides by multiple fission and produce many minute amoeba or pseudopodia spores. Okay, the cyst wall burst and the numerous spores are arranged from this or liberated from this, and each spore become new amoeba, and the process is known as sporulation. Clear this? What is sporulation? And the next is budding. In yeast, the division is unequal. The small cell remains attached with the large parent cell as a bud. Okay, the latter, the bud is detached from the parent body or adult body and lead a separate life. That is known as budding. The budding is common in the yeast and hydra. The budding is three types: exogenous, endogenous, and the one more is, what was the one next one? Exogenous, endogenous, and the next is remember what was the next one we discussed when I taking that portion. We discussed the next one, that is strobilation. Strobilation means the repeated formation of similar segments. Repeated formation of similar segments by the process of budding is called strobilation. Okay, the segmented body is called strobila. Example for this strobilation is Aurelia. Okay, example for this strobilation is Aurelia. Okay, then the next that we discuss, that is after budding, that we discuss, that is zoospores. Zoospores are flagellated, motile, and asexual unicellular spores produced by majority of the algae and certain fungi. But then Chlamydomonas, Phytophthora, that are examples for the zoospores. Next we discuss, that is conidia or conidiophores. Conidia are non-motile and they are produced exogenously, asexual spores seen in the fungus. Okay, example for this conidia are Penicillium and Aspergillus. All this we study in biological classification portion in the last year. Penicillium and Aspergillus are example for this conidia. Next is fragmentation. Fragmentation means the body of the organism breaks into small pieces which later become into a new organism. So algae, fungi, and protonema are the examples for this. Then the in case of regeneration, the whole body is formed from a small fragment. Whole body is formed from a small fragment, that is known as morpholaxis. Okay, so please be careful with this term, morpholaxis. From the small fragment, small piece, a new organism, full organism is forming, that is known as morpholaxis. Okay, the next term is epimorphosis. Epimorphosis means the replacement of lost body part, that happening in the case of the wall lizard. Okay, this is a replacement of lost body part. Replacement of lost body part, that is known as epimorphosis. Epimorphosis, I'm stressing the important points, so please be careful with that points. The next is gemmules. Gemmules means a small group of cells enclosed by a protective coat formed in sponges is known as gemmule. Then these gemmules are totipotent cells. Gemmules having totipotent cell, and these totipotent cells are known as archaeocytes. Okay, so the totipotent cells are present in the gemmules that are known as archaeocytes. On liberation from the gemmule, the archaeocytes germinate to form new sponges. Example is spongilla. Clear? The next is vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction means from the plant body, the new organism is forming, that is known as vegetative reproduction, and they are also the same as of the parent. So otherwise we can say that they are clones. The different vegetative propagation methods are rhizome, tuber, bulb, runner, offset, sucker, bulbils, and leaf buds. So rhizome means under the ground flattened and horizontally growing stem is known as rhizome. It possesses internodes, scale leaf buds, and adventitious roots. Example, ginger.
Okay, the next is tuber, underground stomach modified into a swollen, fleshy, round or oval shaped structure that is known as tuber. It shows eyes which represent nodes bearing scale leaf and bud. Example for this tuber is potato. Next is bulb, underground stomach reduced into a compact disc-like structure with adventitious roots. Okay, and the foods are stored in the fleshy leaves are overlapped into a bulb-like structure. Terminal and lateral buds are also forming. Example for this is onion and garlic. And the next is runner. In runner, it originates above the soil from the axillary buds of the parent plant. It is delicate with a long internodes and runs horizontally. So, adventitious roots are. So, please be careful with the type of root. Here, I am telling adventitious root. Okay. So, adventitious roots are given out of the nodes and fix the plant into the soil. Example for this group is grasses and the strawberry. Then the next is offset. Offset is mainly seen in the water living plants. Example for this is Eichornia and the Pistia. In case of Eichornia and the Pistia, lateral long and slender internodes formed from the axillary buds of the aquatic plants. Axillary bud, here the important one is axillary bud of the aquatic plants. Okay, so if you are making the notes, please be written this type of axillary buds adventitious root in different color pen so you can easily identify or study which type of buds are helping vegetative propagation in these organisms. Clear? In case of sucker, it originates from the underground basal stem of the parent plant. It is stouter and also shorter and grows horizontally and emerges obliquely upward. Chrysanthemum, banana and pineapple are the example for this group. The next one is bulbils. Instead of flowers, here forming the aerial vegetative buds. Okay, so they are developed on the inflorescence axis. Such aerial buds are known as bulbils. On detachment, these bulbils result in new plants. Example for this bulbils is agave and the century plant. Okay, the next is leaf buds. Leaf buds means leaf of many plants have adventitious buds. Such leaf when fall on the ground, their buds develop and root and mature into individual plants. So the example for this group is bryophyllum, begonia and calancho is an example for the leaf buds. Okay, so asexual reproduction is a common among the simple organism. So higher organism having sexual type of reproduction. This asexual reproduction having their own limitation. Okay, so asexual reproduction having their own limitation. So what are the limitations of this asexual reproduction? They are just copies of the parental plant. Okay, no different from the parental plant. So there is never happening a variation. Okay, for a continuing of life, for an evolution, variation is required. Okay, so here I am winding this.